Hi, my name's Andrew Greenfield, and today I'm going to take you on a live demonstration of how IBM security products, Guardium and QRadar, working on top of some IBM storage products, in this case, IBM Flash Arrays, using Safeguarded Copy and Copy Services Manager, will literally prevent Oracle malware and improper database access. Now, I couldn't have done this by myself. First and foremost, I've worked with Shawshank for the last couple years. He's been fantastic. We've also done some other papers and videos together. You'll see the links as well. They deal with Safeguarded Copy and Flash systems. And recently, of course, Renindir and I have been working together with Shawshank on this project. Special thanks to Christopher Volmar, who's security out of Canada, and he's recently joined my team. Now, when we talk about all of this, some people are confused about cyber resiliency. Where do I start? How do I really lock down things? How do I prevent an attack or a ransomware or malware attack vector? And I'll be able to go into a little bit more of this shortly, but we're going to focus today on just an Oracle database and how all these products, once they're configured and set up, will take care of a lot of these what ifs. Now, the key thing is on the left. Cybersecurity is about prevention. This is making sure that we keep the bad actors from even getting into your environment, or at least stopping them if they get access into your environment. The cyber resilience piece, which is not what we're going to show as much today, is about how to recover. Now, actually, we're going to show this in a separate video about the recovery, but you'll see today how we stop the bad actors. And in addition, we add extra layers of protection just in case we have to go into the cyber resilience. Earlier, Shawshank and I did a paper showcasing off how IBM's QRadar could interact with not only Flash systems, but also Brocade or Broadcom switches. Those links are on the screen right here, and they're also in the metadata down below. But also, I need you to consider the entire infrastructure that you're working with. So it's not just an application, it's not just a server, series of servers, clusters, storage, but also your switches. It's a great video that shows off how QRadar can look at how a switch can be protected itself. Now let's take a look at the elements of this demo. First and foremost, while we're not going to show the IBM Flash System GUI, it is the base of what you're about to see. Without its ability to do what's called safeguarded copies or immutable snapshots, none of this would be possible, because most arrays can take snapshots, and that's great, but those snapshots are modifiable and presentable by many different users. And even on other arrays out there, when you try to lock them down into some sort of golden snapshot, they can still be accessed. Not with IBM Flash System, where we actually call these immutable for a very good reason. They're not directly accessible, even by most admins, and even when they are accessible, they are recovered to a separate volume. In other words, the original immutability exists. Now, this is huge because that gives us forensics analysis and validation. We've got over 11 petabytes globally today. Now, let's get into the heart of this particular demo and one of IBM's best kept secrets. IBM's Guardium is a tool meant to be used for all databases as well as operating systems. It doesn't replace your existing controls or antivirus or anything else, but what it does do amazing is the analysis, protection, and response, as well as other actions and items that you can see on the link on screen, as well as in the metadata. And what you're going to see in this particular series of demos is where it's going to watch actions inside the database and then stop the user from doing anything else. So that's not only analysis, that's protection and response. And not only that, it'll actually send those events to QRadar, so QRadar could do even further network and external access. In other words, through the firewalls, the network paths, the switches, and through the storage, which you will see in this particular video. Now, here's a slide that shows a little bit more about Guardium in case you want to read up on it, in case you don't want to see the video. The key thing about it is being proactive and being able to do a lot with security controls, both internally to your database as well as externally, and then being able to do something with that for compliance, auditing, and reporting, and making sure all of this is available to other upstream and downstream parts of your IT ecosystem. Now, this is what you're going to see today. You will see how a user tries to get into an Oracle database and when that person doesn't succeed, or if that person does succeed and they go to a table that they shouldn't, in other words, a table that's classified as sensitive or confidential, how we will immediately take actions both with IBM's Guardium as well as QRadar to take preventative actions. That's right, we will stop the intruder and we'll actually take an extra safeguarded copy, because QRadar will use Copy Services Manager to take another ad hoc immutable snapshot. Now here's the actual detail at its lowest level. You're gonna see proactive monitoring. Guardium's gonna be watching everything as well as QRadar. And then I have three use cases over two different accounts. You can see it, Renindir as well as myself. We are going to log into the Oracle database and then watch what happens. But meanwhile, behind the scenes on IBM's flash storage, we're gonna be doing our safeguarded copies done by Copy Services Manager. And if something is severe enough where something would have damaged the database or malicious, we'll take an extra copy, because not only will that action be stopped by our friends at Guardium, but Guardium will signal that to QRadar, and QRadar will say, hey, because of the severity, and again, you can change this by your own company policies, we'll take an extra safeguarded copy just to be on the safe side. In this use case, I'm gonna show you a typical Oracle user trying to access a table that he should not be. That's right, so in the upper left, you have Copy Services Manager, upper right, you have QRadar, bottom left, you have IBM Guardium, the heart of this, which is gonna start and notice all these actions. Lower right is a CLI, and we're gonna magnify that up. First thing is, let's just show my normal connected user, myself. Now, let me try to access a table I normally shouldn't have access to. This is part of Guardium's classification and discovery that you can set up at the onset, or that it can run against a series of databases. Now watch, instantly I'm disconnected. This is because Guardium said, wait a second, there's no way this user is classified or authorized to access that particular data. Now I'm gonna show you those live messages now that flowed from Guardium to QRadar. You'll see that not only I have this on the QRadar, but they're from Guardium saying, hey, wait a second, this user is trying to access this table and I don't think this should happen. And it's not just one message, it's a few messages, because there's a bunch of different classification items that happened as well. So I was already logged in and it says, wait a second, he's now off the reservation, he's off his normal pattern. So this was sent to both places for further forensic analysis and escalation, as well as investigation. Next, let's get to our next demo. In this use case, I'm gonna show you an Oracle user trying to access a sensitive table that the person should not have access to whatsoever, and notice the different errors. So unlike the other one where I was already logged in, this is where we have a different account now, where the person's gonna log in using maybe compromised credentials and try to access a part of the database that again is marked as either sensitive or confidential. So the person's logged in, we see the connection. Again, notice the magnified view on the upper left. We have Guardium on the other side, and then we have QRadar on the upper right. And you're gonna see this live when that person tries to select from that table. Wait a second, all of a sudden, those are the live messages coming in there, and it's on a sensitive object, obviously that table, and the user's immediately disconnected. Now we're gonna put this all together with an extra safeguarded copy in the next use case, but you can see how quickly and easily this can be applied to different levels of accounts and different sensitive error logs based on the classification of the data or the tables inside your databases. In this particular use case, we're actually gonna do a double series of actions. The first thing I'm gonna do is try to log in, access the data. You'll see I get disconnected, but just to prove the point about how I can do even more, I'll then try to drop that sensitive data. So as you can see, I have my screen magnified to show that I'm already logged in. And so we're going to show off that not only when I log in, I'm able to access my normal stuff, but if I go to a table that I shouldn't be, selecting from this particular table, you'll see a simple read command. It gets logged and escalated to our friends from Guardium and QRadar. And not only that, I'm disconnected, right? You can see the events, there we go. The highly restricted data accessed error message from Guardium to QRadar in the upper right, and there I've highlighted it. But now let's take it to the next level. Let's say I log back in now, and this time I'll try to drop a table. So here we are magnified, and there it is, just if you need to see it up above, the original disconnect. So now I'm in again, and this could look very suspicious, especially to Guardium or QRadar. So I'm in again, and now let's try to drop that sensitive table. So not only did I not have access to read, let's see if I can even try to delete some of the data. As you can see, I'm immediately disconnected because Guardium saw what was going on. And then not only that, because of the severity of the command where I was trying to maliciously do something, it was escalated not just to QRadar, but also to Copy Services Manager. You're gonna see some of those other error messages right here where that custom rule says to Copy Services Manager, hey, because of this suspicious activity, I want you to take an extra immutable snapshot on the flash array of the entire database. No problem. CSM does this in a matter of seconds and takes a copy of that data. And you can actually see other errors continuing to flow in as well as with that CSM. Notice the extra event, the suspicious activity. And this is again part of Guardium working hand in hand with QRadar, and the screen you're seeing here is from QRadar, so it can actually show off even more of the network functions to help trace back where this login came from a switch, from a firewall, from anything therein. And now, just to show off a little bit more, here's my CSM, and it shows that new ad hoc backup as well as all the other immutable backups or the safeguarded copies that are automatically going on. And as you can see, or a database on my Macbeth, which is an IBM Flash System Array. Thanks for watching. I can't wait to do more with you. Please reach out, and I look forward to seeing you soon.